صالحا ومجددا فرنوا بنذر طاهر وجنان.
وكذلك أيضا يؤخذ من هذه الآية الكريمة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو خاتم الرسل، لأن الله قال قد خلت من قبله الرسل، فأل هذه تفيد العموم، الرسل جنس الرسل، لم يبقى رسول، ولو كان المراد غير ذلك لقال قد خلت من قبله رسل، لكنه قال قد خلت من قبله الرسل، يعني كل الرسل، يعني كل الرسل، يعني كل الرسل، يعني كل الرسل.
Alhamdulillah, on live television, Dr. Muhammad Salah, one of the most famous Salafi scholars, accepted the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. He was forced to accept that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is included in the messengers mentioned in chapter 3, verse 145 of the Holy Quran, where Allah the Almighty states that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is nothing but a messenger. All messengers before him have already passed away. The Salafi Muslims and Muslims of other sects try to deceive the innocent Muslims and say that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is excluded from al-rusul in chapter 3 verse 145. Dr. Muhammad Salah exposes them badly. On live television, a Muslim asked Dr. Muhammad Salah, is Hazrat Isa alayhi salam included in al-rusul in chapter 3 verse 145, where Allah the Almighty states that all messengers before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam have passed away? Dr. Muhammad Salah agreed that yes, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam and all other messengers are included.
Of course, he is included. Of course, is included. Of course, is included. The word khalat, يعني passed. She's referring to ayah, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبِلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ انْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبَ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا وَسَيَجِزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. And this ayah was revealed after mass of the Battle of Uhud, when people heard the rumor that the Prophet ﷺ was killed, so they dispersed the way. So Allah says, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدَ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبِلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Muhammad is not but a messenger, whom messengers before him have come and passed. Okay? I know where you're coming from. The ayah refers to the fact that there have been many messengers before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So whether he's killed, whether he died a normal death, would you guys give up on your faith and go back on your heels? You should not, of course. So it refers to all the prophets before Muhammad, including Jesus, the son of Mary, may peace be upon him, and his mother. So it refers to all the prophets before Muhammad, including Jesus, the son of Mary, may peace be upon him, and his mother. So it refers to all the prophets before Muhammad, including Jesus, the son of Mary, may peace be upon him, and his mother.
Let us hear one of the most famous English-speaking Sunni scholars accept that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is included in the verse.
Isa, peace be upon him, part of this ayah, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. The answer is yes. The answer is yes. The answer is yes.
The very first consensus of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was that all messengers before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have passed away. In Akrabul Mawarid, it is written that when this is used for a man, it means death. We see the same in many other Arabic dictionaries, including Asasul Balagha. Lisanul Arab also says the same, that Khala Fulanun Idha Mata. The same is also written in Tajul Urus. Your favorite Quranic commentaries also give the same meaning for khala, like Tafsir al-Qurtubi. There is also a famous narration of Hazrat Jarud radiallahu anhu. Let us hear this incident from your own scholar Uthman al-Khamis.
طبيعي إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون أفإن مت فهم الخالدون وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم قال فإن محمدا قد مات.
Alhamdulillah, we just heard him quote the very same verses Hazrat Ahmad alayhis-salam gives in Izala-e-Oham to prove the death of Hazrat Isa alayhis-salam. He then quoted this narration of Hazrat Jarud, which is narrated by Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab in his book on Sirat-e-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam under chapter 3 verse 144. Now the only excuse a Muslim may present is that Uthman al-Khamis had a slip of tongue. However, this is not possible because the narration mentions Hazrat Isa alayhi salam by name. If you have not yet subscribed, make sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you can get notifications for every new video. Also, make sure to like and comment on the video and follow on Twitter and Instagram.
صلي على محمد صلي على سفينا صلي على محمد.